day and age to read any good news on the newspaper page. And love and tradition of the grand design, some people say it's even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls, 'cause all I see is a tower of dreams, real love bursting out of every scene.
The purpose of our work still is to take stock dowel rods, cut them into smaller dowel rod pieces, and then lay them using a CNC lathe to create a pawn that is then delivered to whoever wants the pawn.
Our process is started through an MCR latch which turns on the electrical components to all of our work cell, ensuring that we have air and electricity as needed. A double operator start is then pressed to allow the process to begin.
Alright, so the scorebot moves over to the shoot fixture where it will then check if there's a dowel rod available to pick up. Here you can see that there is a dowel rod available to pick up, so it picks it up. The dowel rod is then moved over by the scorebot to the chop saw fixture.
Once the dowel rod is delivered to the chop saw fixture, a cylinder pushes forward the dowel rod until it hits a limit switch, at which point two other clamps come down, which hold down the dowel rod into position while the chop saw cuts it. This process is repeated three times until four separate, equal length parts of dowel rod have been cut. There is a crosstalk between the chop saw and the scorebot that prevents them from ever colliding while the chop saw is cutting and while the scorebot is trying to pick up a piece.
Here you can see the scorebot picking up a piece that has been cut by the chop saw. It will take this piece and reposition it using a fixture, which we have conveniently placed on the chop saw fixture itself. After repositioning, the scorebot will then take this piece and, using precise positioning, will take it and put it into the chuck of the lathe to be transformed into a corn piece. Here you can see the precise positioning that a scorebot enables us to use. The piece will be put inside of the chuck, closed down, and then the scorebot will exit the lathe's area.
Here you can see the CNC lathe lathing out a pawn piece from our previously cut dowel rod. The process usually takes about 4 minutes, but through the magic of video editing, we've sped it up to only 40 seconds. If the safety feature is ever engaged, the lathe will stop lathing until it has been unengaged. After lathing, the scorebot, once again using precise positioning, picks up the pawn from the lathe and then delivers it to the consumer.
Using precise positioning, the scorebot will then take the pawn and then deliver it to the handy dandy delivery chute.
Overall, the process gives us a perfect pawn piece usable for chess or checkers.
For this work cell, we realized we needed multiple voltages to deal with all the applications, so we selected 4 different I/O racks to deal with this problem. All right.
You can see both breaking the light curtain and hitting the e-stop will halt the program until the operator starts it again.